Robert, ComProfiles is now a methodology which is on the market since 30 years. And many, many people are thinking that ComProfiles is a profiler. So it's a kind of, putting people into categories. What is your opinion about that?
Okay. First of all, I kept ComProfiles for myself during a long, long time. And fortunately, some people convinced me to share it, but finally it's pretty recent. It's, let's say, this last 10 years, and more the recent years. That's the first point. So ComProfiles is not that known on the market. And but when people say, oh, it's another method of profiling, I cannot say it is not, but at the same time, it's not the way I see ComProfile. For me, the profile are something, but they are just a source of information to do other things better. That means it's more a method to improve the relationship between the people, or to improve interpersonal communication. And what is the most important there? It's not the profiles. The most important is the capacity of people to manage stress in growth, staying in growth, that means with all their talents and their resources, and to be able to mobilize their energy to give energy to other people, and to minimize the period we are in survival. That means we lose the command of our behavior, whatever the profile is. So finally, the profile doesn't say anything about the level of development of a person. And so if I have to present ComProfiles, I would be inclined not to speak about the profiles first, because some method of profiling became an industry of profiles. They sell profiles. I'm not going to criticize that, because very often they do a good job, defining their profiles and all that. But at the same time, for me, it is not at all the goal. The goal is to improve the capacity of leadership of people, to be the best, support for, improvement of the capacity of people to really cope with stress in the best way.
So in a certain way, you're saying, the movie Matrix with Neo?
Yes.
So in a little bit, it's to decode the matrix, to understand how relations are working.
Yes.
And in decoding what is going on and not being influenced anymore by it, but handling it, is the true goal of ComProfiles.
Yes, but the method don't say about the profiles, and we have to be very humble about the profiles, because when we deliver a profile to somebody, it is not his or her profile. And no method gives the real profile of a person, because nobody is able to do that. What we receive when we receive a profile from any method is just, the profile of a category of people who are answering in a similar way to our own answer. So that means it is what we get is not specific of us. It is specific of a category of people who can be enormous. And so since it is not our profile, we have to take the freedom, the liberty to recognize ourselves or not in what is described. Mm. So it's a source of information, just a source of information. And that's the first point. So we have to really be in a mood to say, okay, what is relevant for me here? and not to, to feel defined by a profile.
Okay, it doesn't have to be dogmatic, you know, so...
And the second point is, the profile doesn't say anything about the level of maturity of the person. That means the capacity of this person to stay in growth under stress, or the vulnerability of this person, in the opposite way, to go into survival under low stress, even. So the most important is growth and survival. It is not a profile. And so that's when we are in difficult situation of communication, most of the time there is survival somewhere. Either in our interlocutors, maybe we could be in survival ourselves. And the key point is what? If we have somebody in survival in front of us, how are we going to help this person coming back to growth? And we have to use our potential of growth to help this person cope with survival, cope with stress, to go out of survival and stress. What do we do in this case? The key point, why are we in under stress? Because we have deficit of resources. Why are we in survival? Because in a situation where we have a deficit of resources, there is automatic commands inside of ourselves, governed by fears, fear of not having the energy we need or the satisfaction of our needs, So what do we have to do? First, give positive energy to these people. So that means to nurture their needs. That's the first point.
So in fact, what you're saying is we all have tendencies to fall in traps.
Yeah, survival is a trap.
Is
putting enormous traps in front of us, survival is infectious. So we can fall into the trap so easily.
And we're pulling others in too.
Yes.
And once we are in the trap, we don't have any more choices in the way we are acting.
No, it is we think the way we behave is the only
is
way
the only
possible.
Right. Yeah. And in fact, the idea of the concept of comprofiles with survival and growth is to get an understanding how you can pull yourself first, because it all starts with you.
Yeah.
How can you pull yourself out of the trap?
Okay. And,
and then helping others to pull out of the trap.
Yeah. So, of course, the starting point is our economy of stress.
Yes.
That means we have to take care of ourselves to be able to mobilize resources. To mobilize resources, we need to have resources. If we don't take care of ourselves and we don't recharge our battery, if you don't have any emotional capital, it's difficult to mobilize the emotional capital.
What I'm discovering more and more is that I see people, they're even not aware that they're trapped.
Yeah, because when we are trapped, when we are in survival, we are not conscious of it.
Exactly.
Yeah.
And that's a starting point. I think in comprofiles, the starting point is understanding when you are trapped.
Yeah. And to be able to put that into perspective.
Exactly. So that means on a meta level to understand, wow, what is just going on here.
And plus, the more we get aware of our mechanism of stress and survival, the more we are able to see it faster, let's say.
So decoding the matrix.
Yeah.
So decoding the relational interactions.
Yes.
In your own psychological system and regarding others. Yeah.
And there is another point also. In comprofiles, we use everything which has been done before. And so I didn't invent anything. I use the knowledge which is available. And for instance, we are trying to do the best use of emotional intelligence, for instance. And I would say what we propose is emotional intelligence in action. What is emotional intelligence about? To understand my own emotions, and especially the impact of my emotion also on other people.
Mm.
And I notice that sometimes, either because I don't express my emotion or I express my emotion in an excessive way, you know, exaggerated way, my expression of the emotion is not appropriate and has a bad impact on the other one. Of course, it's the same, what I can see about myself, we can see it on other people. So the emotional intelligence is to do what? To understand the authentic emotion which is behind the expression which is not appropriate, and to help facilitate the expression by the other person of his authentic or her authentic emotion.
So it has a lot to do with first listening to yourself.
Yes.
And listening what is going on into you.
Be clear about yourself.
Exactly. And then listening to others.
Yeah. Because if you are not clear about yourself,
you're blind.
Preoccupied by yourself and you cannot be available for the other one.
You're blind.
Yeah.
You're blind.
Yeah. So, and in reality, if you take care a little, you know, of yourself, that means if you have a good enough economy of stress, you are available for the other one, so you privilege, you give the absolute priority to the other one, and you focus on the other one, and to do what? To understand his needs and his emotions and his objectives and all that. And you're gonna, okay, manage your, you know, adapt your behavior to that.
And you know, that's a nice explanation because, you know, typically with this idea of you're getting a profile and then you know who you are and what you are, is simplifying it to putting people in a box and saying that's the way you are.
For me, it's a dead end street.
Not just that, it's also counterproductive because it would mean that, 7 billion people can be put in four boxes.
Yeah.
And that there are just four ways of acting or reacting, which is completely dump. Yeah. That would be a simplification to a grade, which is even dangerous.
And you know, there is another reason for that, everything we said, but when you receive a profile, you have only the description of your dominant, you know, behaviors, dominant needs and dominant behaviors. You don't have the rest, but you are a complete person. And so that is not described because it would be too complex.
Exactly.
Know?
And in fact, all of us have all different ways of all needs inside of us. Some more dominant, some less dominant. And depending on the situation, each of those can pop up and influence your behavior if you're not in balance with yourself.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Exactly. There is also another point which is very important. For 70% of us, people evolve in the priority of needs. So during a period of their life, they put in place behaviors which are at the service of the predominant needs. But since we, for 70% of the people, don't stay with the same predominance in needs in their life, they change priority.
Don't they? Okay.
Yeah, they change priority. So that means maybe during 10 years or 15 years or 20 years, they are with a priority, a family of needs which is predominant. And after they go to another priority. So they put in place new behaviors at the service of the new.
Oh, that's interesting. I thought it's pretty constant.
No, it's not. It is not constant. And for some people, it is constant all their life. But for a large majority of people, it is not constant.
Okay.
And so it changes. So finally, you develop two types, for instance, at least two types of behaviors. And some are older than the other one, and some are new at a given moment of your life. But you are the person you are, but you are also the person you have been.
You've been, yeah.
And very often when stress is very, very important, you go back to your
fundamental profiles.
The fundamental profiles,
yeah.
Which is your basis. And so, for the people, they have to manage all that. They have to get all this information and to, and after to analyze, okay, what is the alchemy between one priority and another one?
But whatever, at the end, I understand it's important to understand the mechanism. So understanding the logic of how needs are influencing your way of behaving and thinking and feeling, if you're understanding this pattern, if you can decode this pattern, despite if it's a relational or whatever pattern, then you're up to the situation.
It's the starting point.
That's the starting point.
Of your improvement. Yeah. That's starting. After you know, in CompuFest we work a lot how to, you know, manage behaviors in survival. So we equip the people, you know, in a very, very strong way. But that becomes a sport afterwards. You have to practice it.
Okay, but that's on the other poor point. Now I've been on how to understand it for yourself. Yeah. Once you are in balance, once you are in a good mood with energy, then you can start to identify survival mode on others and try to create a relation or a communication which helps them to go out of the trap.
But once again, we have to understand that what is going to be the most in favor of our own balance is to give energy to the other one, because if we give energy to the other one, if we cope with the inappropriate expression of emotions, you know, these people are going to go out of survival and are going to bring energy to us.
And I think sort of out of my experience, there are two ways. There are people who do that by nature.
Yeah.
They do that because they're talented. But with CompuFiles, you can learn to do that.
Oh, you can work on that.
You can learn to do that. And by decoding the patterns, to be able to really help others to come out of their
Their survival. That's the main.
That's the idea.
That's the core of the method. Yeah, and like that, you know, you see that, when you are in growth, you are in growth because you are able to mobilize your resources. That means you have resources to mobilize, and you are able to relate. And giving resources to the other one, supporting the other one to go out of survival, finally, the exchange is going to be positive for you. You are in a virtuous circle. In survival, that's exactly the opposite. You are not able to mobilize your energy, so you are going to become defensive, stingy with your energy and all that. No satisfaction in the interaction with the other one, and finally, your lack of emotional capital is going to increase.
Right.
So in psychology, it's like in finance. Yeah. If you are rich, you become richer. If you are poor, you become poorer. Mm.
And you know, that's what I learned when I had first contact. You know, we met many years, and I remember when we worked together also on CompuFiles. It was you're getting a kind of alarm button, which is giving you a signal, whoa, be aware, now you're falling, just about to fall into a trap. And just understanding the signals, red flags, signals, brings you in a situation not to fall into survival. Yeah. Even if you have a lack of energy, even if you are just about to fall in, just having the signal and that's stop, what is just happening there? Then you come back, and maybe even in a situation you can say to whoever you have a chat with, I'm sorry, I'm just not in my balance. It's just not okay what I'm doing. I'm just in a situation where I'm not in balance.
It's a fight for life. It lasts all our life, because we can improve ourselves, but in some cases, you know, we fall back in the trap. You know?
It's we have all needs.
Yeah.
and we are all striving for getting those needs satisfied.
Yeah, exactly.
And so it's a normal, it's a human life. So yeah. That's part of our of our human beings. But the one is, are you just living it without knowing what is going on and falling pretty often in traps? Or are you able
to be aware,
to go one step higher,
yeah,
and to look on what is happening? So that's a meta level.
Meta level.
Yeah.
That's it. If you, you know, the basis of growth are always the same: to be aware of yourself and to be aligned, to be able to put things into perspective, to take a distance towards yourself first,
yes,
and towards the situation, yes, and that, you know, makes you able to really listen to the person and to show empathy and to understand the other one.
So in fact, we could even summarize it in saying comp profiles is a concept of self-awareness.
Yes.
And of relational awareness.
Yeah. Interpersonal awareness.
Yes.
Exactly. And from the interpersonal awareness, to come and to support the other one.
To get communication tools to solve it.
And to be able to change the terms of the exchange with the other one and to make an exchange which is profitable
so not
for
just,
both parties.
Not just discovering it, but also solving it.
Yeah, so. Okay.
Thank you, Robert.
Thank you.